Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about signal noise ratios. We're going to expand on the term a little bit so you can get a little bit more understanding. Our system, speakers, amplifiers, cables, it's all a system, okay? All systems have noise, all systems have signals, right? So our goal with amplifiers, speakers, cables, and room is to create a system where we're minimizing distortion and improving resolution. That's the goal, right? So there's a synergy that occurs. We have speakers, we have our amplifiers, we have the cables, we have the chair, we have our room, all of these things combined to produce the sound that we want. So there's a synergy there. 1 + 1 = 3, right? So let's just, for purposes of discussion, let's assign some noise levels to each one of our components so we can get a feel for what we're looking at here. So we have a power cable, let's say 5 to 10%. I'm just trying to illustrate this. You know, these are not exact numbers, but we're trying to illustrate a point and a concept here. So please don't email me and say, well, how did you come up with that number? I didn't. I'm trying to illustrate a point here. So 5 to 10% for power cables, let's say amp noise, 5 to 10%. That's probably really high. Today, the total harmonic distortion on amps is very, very low. Speaker noise, 10 to 20%. The speaker is the weakest link in this whole chain next to the room, okay? And we're going to talk about that. Speaker noise, 10 to 20%. But look at room. The room noise, pressure and reflections, causes 50 to 60% distortion in the signal. So it's the highest of all of our components, and it is a component. If you don't think it is, come to my studio here and listen. You'll know immediately the power of the room, and you'll know what you've been missing all these years. What do we got? We got room noise. We got pressure, low frequency, and reflections, reverberation. That's what we have to balance out. Low frequency pressure, mid and high reflections, right? Fundamental and harmonics defined. We must have the resolution high enough in the room that we hear both the fundamentals and the harmonics. Remember, the emotion, the attachment to our music is in the harmonics. And most rooms destroy harmonics with their size, with the distance from the speakers to the room boundary surfaces, the walls. Just a whole host of issues, improper material types in the room. There's just hundreds of ways to produce distortion in rooms, okay? So the room, it's the largest distortion-producing component of our system, yet we pay very, very little attention to it. Why is that? There's a lot of reasons. Marketing, amplifier, speaker companies, they've done a good job at convincing people to buy this speaker or this amplifier. We see it all the time in the pro world. We see this example all the time in the pro world, which is complete nonsense. Buy our speaker system to manage your reverberation in your church. What a lie. An out and out lie. And people don't understand the physics behind the lie. So they buy into it. We're working with a church now that's bought 4 PA systems to solve a 6-second full range reverb time. Think about that. Over $1 million in PA systems, and they still have a 6-second reverb time. Think about that one. Okay. So, what are we going to do? We got to think the room as gear. It's part of our system. It's the major part of our system. It's the one that produces the most distortion. So we have to treat it. Okay. Let me give you an example. Got a call from a client the other day. He asked me what I thought of this interconnect cable and these speaker cables. I added them all up. It was $23,000. I said, for $23,000, you can treat your whole room, all the frequencies of the room. For $23,000, you can fix all of the distortion here. Okay, not just here. Here. Why would you spend that much to go after a little bit of distortion when you could spend $23,000 to $25,000 and fix the whole room and enjoy everything? Once again, not seeing the forest for the trees. Not seeing, looking at each individual component without looking at the synergy of all the components together to get the resolution that you need. So look at your system as a complete system and include your room in that system, because it accounts for most of the distortion that you're going to hear. Our cables and amplifiers today are wonderful. I haven't bought gear for 20, 25 years. Of course, with new studios, I have to. So I've noticed the changes in the last 20 years. Speakers are still the weak link in the chain. I think they always will be. But power cables, amplifiers, interconnect speaker cables, DACs, they've all have very high resolution. In fact, the distortion, I don't even think is audible in most cases. So start stepping back, look at the whole situation. Don't look at the tree, look at the whole forest and try to come up with a budget that works. I will tell you this, if you spend $20,000, $25,000 fix your room, you won't spend $20,000 on cables. You won't need to. Most people, when they're debating between spending money on room treatment or new gear, if they choose the room treatment, they keep their existing gear. All the reasons they bought it come back because they hear all those reasons again. So treat your room. It's the biggest signal-to-noise ratio issue in the whole system. Hope this helps. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video, and if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to, so please do that, because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions, and I usually get a chance every couple days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum, and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis, so that'll help you. Thank you.